Yo, what's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. So we are a little over a day into the official launch of Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. And if you have played this game already, you probably have noticed how difficult it is to level up here in the game, not only just for your soldier, but also for your weapon, so you can go ahead and unlock different camos here. So in today's video, what we're going to do is we're going to give you the five best tips to help you guys level up both your soldier and your weapons a lot faster here to make things a little easier so you can get those camos unlocked. So you can hit first prestige, because even for me, man, this is probably one of the hardest Call of Duty games that I've played in a while, that to hit a prestige in, just because the leveling system seems like it's so slow. But I did notice a couple different things that I needed to start working on here as I started playing last night, so hopefully some of these tips will go ahead and help you out as well. But before we get into the tips, I do want to ask each and every single one of you guys, do me a big favor, smack that like button and subscribe to the channel if you are brand new. We are on that road to 25,000 subscribers. We're less than 50 away, so if you're new, if you're part of that 95% of the people that watch our videos and you're not yet subbed yet, do me a big favor, hit that sub button. It would really mean a lot. Let's try to hit 25,000 subscribers as fast as possible. But without further ado, let's get into some of these tips, and hopefully these will help you guys out as well. Starting off with tip number one, this one might be a little like basic and easy for you guys, but I'm gonna go into detail and explain this one a little more, because there's a couple extra little hidden features that you might not know about yet. So the first tip to leveling up faster, obviously double XP is a pretty big thing. It gives you double the amount of XP that you would get per game. The way that you can do this is there is the Dew and Doritos bundle basically added into this game. So if you go to a convenience store and you buy a bag of Doritos, or you buy a bottle of Mountain Dew, you will get maybe like 45 minutes to an hour worth of double XP for that purchase. That's not something that I'm personally gonna do, but it is just another option for you guys. But there is some other ways to get some extra XP in the game without spending money here. So basically, if you do play on PlayStation, there's a couple different exclusives that will be available. First things first, one of the PS exclusives this year is there's gonna be double XP weekends once a month that is gonna be just exclusive to players that are on the PlayStation 4 or the PlayStation 5. So that is huge. If you guys are on PlayStation, make sure you guys take advantage of those weekends so you can level up a lot faster. But the other option is there is party XP that is another exclusive this year. So if you are playing on the PlayStation 4 or the PlayStation 5, make sure you're playing in a party at all times. It doesn't even matter if you don't know the person you're playing with, just invite recent friends or recent players until you get somebody in your lobby, because you can utilize that extra XP that you're gonna get in game. It does make a really big difference. Unfortunately, I think this only relies on your soldier, not necessarily your weapons, but that is just more XP so you can go ahead and level up to the higher levels a lot faster. So definitely make sure you're utilizing as much XP as possible, those double XP Doritos bags, and also making sure if you're on PlayStation, make sure you take advantage of that. So anyway, moving on to tip number two, we're gonna talk some challenges here. Now there is a lot of brand new challenges here in Black Ops Cold War, similar to what we saw back in Black Ops 4 and Black Ops 3, where they had a lot of weapon challenges, and they also had like Dark Ops challenges that you can work on the side as well, just to get some extra XP per game. These things are really, really huge. You need to make sure you're taking advantage of them per weapon as well. You do have certain challenges for each weapon that will give you additional XP, not even including the challenges that are included for your weapon camos already. So if you guys are not utilizing these challenges, make sure you take advantage of them, because if you add that on and you even add double XP on at the same time, you are going to get so much XP per game just for the fact that you completed a challenge with a double XP on. Now let's move on to tip number three here, and this is going to be play objective-based game modes. Now, one of the most popular game modes here in Call of Duty history is Team Deathmatch. If you're playing Team Deathmatch, I'm sorry, you're just not going to get a lot of XP. The purpose of that game is literally just shoot and kill your enemies, and that is about it. But if you're playing a game mode like Domination or Hardpoint, you're going to get so much more XP per kill that you're going to get as well. If you're running around the map and you're getting kills in Domination or Hardpoint, yeah, you'll get a couple extra kills, but if you're playing that objective at the same time, it's gonna even double down your XP that game. So say you're on a Hardpoint or you're on a Domination flag and you get a double kill or you get a triple kill, all of a sudden those three kills you're getting is gonna get bonus XP as well, because you're also playing the objective, and then you're gonna go ahead and cap that flag or cap that Hardpoint. You're gonna get even more XP on top of that as well. So doubling down, making sure you're playing objective-based game modes is super, super beneficial. And I'm even going even further into this as well. And if you play hardcore on objective-based modes, you're gonna get even more XP as well. I know some people might not be comfortable playing hardcore because it's literally pretty much take one bullet and you die. But if you do play this, you are really going to get a lot of XP, not only from just playing the objective and getting kills on the objective, but as I transfer into my next point here, going to tip number four, the medals that you get per kill in your games are really, really beneficial as well, and you will get a lot of XP. So if I go back to my point on playing in hardcore. Now let's say you're playing the objective in a hardcore game and you're using an assault rifle. Most of the time when you're using an assault rifle, it's a one-shot kill. And if you get that one-shot kill, and it's maybe even a headshot, you're adding in so much more XP just from those medals alone. So let's just add this up real quick. You get a kill, you get XP. It's an objective-based kill, so you get even more XP. You're playing hardcore, so you're gonna get a one-shot kill, and that's gonna be another medal that's gonna add XP to it. And then you're gonna get a headshot on top of that as well. So that's now 4 to 5 times more XP you got for that one kill, just because you're playing hardcore and the objective. So that is so beneficial. If you are not playing hardcore and you really want to level up faster, definitely try to take advantage of that. I promise you, it's going to make a really big difference, and you're going to notice how much faster you're not only leveling up your weapons, but you're also leveling up your games, so you can go ahead and prestige. Now let's move on to the last tip here. Going on streaks while playing the objective is super, super huge. Like I said earlier, OBJ modes is definitely beneficial, but going on a streak at the same time is going to even add more to it as well. So if you go on a bloodthirsty, if you go on, even if you get a nuclear for example, you're going to get so much XP from the amount of streaks that you're just building up on here, and it's really going to help you out a ton. Like I said before, with the medals are huge. You can get up to like 500 XP per some of these medals if you get like headshots or one-shot kills. Now, those things really do add up over time. So adding on your streaks as well, where you get like a bloodthirsty, you get a relentless, that's going to even add more XP to you as well. And playing the objective while getting those streaks, it's overkill. So the biggest tip I can tell you guys this year to ranking up fast, make sure you're being an OBJ player. Don't be that guy that just sits on a head glitch in the back of the map the entire time and just doesn't really care what your team's doing. Help your team out, go for the win and see how it works. Cause I can tell you guys right now, the match bonus that you get for just winning the game as well will be a big benefit to you as well. So don't be that one guy that just sits in the back of the map or sits in a corner and doesn't really move. You're not gonna level up fast, and you're really going to struggle just to get any gun gold or just to prestige once in this game. And just playing aggressive is going to be super beneficial, and that is definitely going to be the move this year. I really like the fact that Treyarch kind of like is like catering to the aggressive player this year, and we'll see what happens. Maybe they'll tinker the XP system a little bit here as we move on here into the life cycle of Cold War, but as of right now, it still takes a really long time to level up. So these tips, hopefully they did help you guys out a little bit. One other like side tip that I'll give you guys real quick, I'm not even gonna add this into the list, it's just like a bonus one here, is take advantage of that assault pack. That is, I believe, one like the little the pieces of equipment that you get, like similar to like where you would put the field mic on. If you use that assault pack and you drop that down and you get kills with that, you get like plus 25 XP per kill you get with that as well, and you also get XP for your teammates that are picking that up on the ground as well. So just a little extra XP for you there. I'm not going to add that to the list, but that is just a little bonus one if you guys wanted to add that in there as well. But anyway, those are the 5 best tips to help you guys rank up as fast as possible here in Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any other tips to rank up fast. Maybe it'll help me out, maybe it'll help some of you guys out in the comment section as well. But again, thank you all so much for watching today's video. If you have not already, once again, smack that like button and subscribe to the channel if you are brand new. We are less than 50 subscribers away from 25k. Please, if you have not already, help us get that goal as soon as possible. It really means a lot. But anyway, without further ado, I'll catch you all in the next video. Have a great rest of your day, and peace out.